Hello students, myself Dr. Gajendra Purohit and you are watching our YouTube channel where I upload videos for Engineering Mathematics B.Sc. Today I will teach you Vector Calculus, the next topic where I will teach you how to find the divergent and curl. And what are the specific conditions applied when dealing with any vector that is solenoidal or irrotational. We will also discuss its concept here, so listen carefully. Let's say we are given any vector point function and we have to proceed with its differentiation. So we are aware of this, that the divergent of f here is del dot f. In the previous class, I covered gradient calculations and related concepts plus basic vector concepts. Check I tab if you missed it. The link is given in description. So students, here what is the meaning of divergent of f? If we have to find the divergent of a vector point function, students, it is del dot f. We write del as follows: I del by del x, j del by del y plus k del by del z is, and listen students, this f here is ultimately vector, so let's assume it is of this type, and like this, j f plus k f1 f2 and f3, here it is a dot product, so we know that f1, that will become I dot I1, so del f1 into del x, del f2 upon del y, and del f3 upon del z. So the divergent is always a scalar, right? Because here the components of I, j and k are not present, right? So pay attention to this. Suppose we are given a function, if you calculate its divergent, then it's same. We will put its value f, then I dot will be I1, j dot will be j1, k dot will be k1. We can also calculate this directly. How will we do this? Del by del x of coefficient of I, right? This will come. And students, remember f1 is the coefficient of I, right? Plus del by del y of. So what will be the coefficient of j? 2x square by z, and del by del z of minus 3y z square, right? You will differentiate this with respect to x, its partial derivative. If we do this with respect to y, then it will be 2x square z. And when we do with respect to z, it will be negative 6yz. And students, here if it says to calculate on 1, 1, 1, then whatever value we are getting, like here, it's divergent of f. In divergent, what will we do? We'll put a point at 1, 1, 1. So here put 1, 1. So this will be 1, 2 and minus 6. 1 plus 2 minus 6, that's equal to minus 3. Here we get value for its divergent, right? Ultimately, whatever f we have, when we do this with it, then I dot I1. So the first coefficient of I, its derivative is done with respect to x. Coefficient of j is derivative with respect to y. Coefficient of k is derivative with respect to z. This way, divergence. Value is obtained. Now, if we have vector point function and its divergent becomes 0. So that vector point function we have here is called solenoidal vector. Right? So, a similar question is asked in exam, that if there is vector point function and its divergent value becomes 0, then what do we have? Solenoidal vector. Like we are given f, if we find its divergent. So, how do we calculate divergent? I will share a trick with you. Divergent of f, this I, with respect to x is 1. J with respect to y, derivative is 1. And this 1 with respect to z is minus 2. It results in 0. So, f will be solenoidal vector. Right? Let's move on. So now let's talk about how to calculate curl. If we are given any vector point function here, and here we are asked to calculate the value of curl. So students, here curl means del cross f, right? So here what will we get? It will be I del by del x, right? J del by del y and k del by del z. And here the f given, let's say this f that is given to us is vector. So I f1 plus j f2 plus k f3, right? So students, here what will we be getting? Cross, then I. F1 plus JF2 plus KF3 will be obtained. So students, what is the correct method to obtain cross product? I explained this in previous video also. You can check it there. So here it will come. Del by del X, del by del Y and del by del Z. Here F1, F2 and F3, right? We will write IJK coefficients here. Write IJK coefficients. Then its determinant's value will be the value of its curl, right? So calculate its determinant and your work will be completed. Let's say, for example, we have this question, right? And this question asks, what will be its curl? So students, this will be del. We'll get this value instead of f. So we'll get this in place of f, and the ijk coefficients will come here. What will their coefficients be? It is xy square. This will be 2x square zy. This is negative 3y z square. How will we get this I? If we do this with it, then what will be its derivative with respect to y? Minus 3z square. Minus, right? We will get minus. this with respect to z, what will we get? 2. X square y, then minus j, remember. Then we'll do it with respect to x, not there, so 0. Then with respect to z, not there, so 0, right? Then here, okay? And students, if we are taking this with respect to x, we will get 4xyz minus. And this is done with respect to y, we will get 2xy, right? So we will get this value. And if we see here, if from the value, we will take minus as common, right? Then we will get here 3z square plus 2x square y, and we will get plus 0j. And students, here we will get its value
4xyz minus of
2xy multiplied by k. If we are told that its curl needs to be calculated on 1, 1, 1. So there is no need to worry. Whatever value of curl we got, in that you can do 1, 1, 1. Wherever x, y, z are there, put 1, 1, 1. Do it only when it is asked. If we put that, what will we get? 2. And this will become minus 5. And plus, we will get here 0j, right? And if we put here, it will be 4 minus 2. That's 2k. So all this will give us the value of curl. Now, let us discuss about what is an irrotational vector. If we have any vector point function, its curl becomes 0. Then the F, this is called as irrotational. We also call this primitive and a conservative vector field, right? These are two names given to it. When we will study further, we will use this and I will tell you then. So students, if we have any vector point function and its curl is 0, then what is it called? It is called an irrotational vector. If we have this F given and you have to find its curl, then what will we do? Same ijk, then del by del x, del by del y, del by del z, and write coefficients of ijk here. And when we calculate its determinant, 0 is coming. Then the F we will be getting is irrotational vector, right? Now, let's look at some questions here. A is constant vector and R is position vector. Constant vector is always denoted as A1i plus A2j plus A3k. Position vector is written xi plus yj plus zk. You are being told that its divergent will be 0. And the curl we will be getting is 2a. Let's find A cross R, cross product of both. That is ijk, A1, A2, A3. And xyz. We calculate the value of its determinant, its I. A2z minus A3y, right? Minus j. A1z minus A3x, and here it's k. It will be A1y minus A2x. And we will get the value. Now we will find its divergent. How do we find divergent? If you have to find divergent of A cross R, so remember what we did. This I, we take its derivative with respect to x, right? We do del by del x of A2z minus A3y. Students, it will be 0. We will take derivative of j with respect to y. So, del by del y of this will be minus. A1z. We will get minus a3x plus the k terms derivative will be with respect to z. So, del by del z of a1y, a2x. So, we know that its value will be 0. So, in this way, here we can very easily prove it. Now, here let's talk about that. You are being told that its curl that we'll be getting is 2a, right? So, let's calculate the curl. Question being asked is the curl of A cross R. It wants to convey that del cross, A cross R, right? So students, what do we have with us? I, J, K. Then we will get del by del X, del by del Y, and del by del Z. For A cross R, we will have coefficient of I here. There is a slight space issue here. So what I will do is make it a little bigger. Let's take this here and take this here, right? So this will be A2Z minus A3Y. Then this will be, I will take the minus inside, right? So, students, here we will be getting A3x minus A1z, right? And students, here we will get it as A1y minus A2x, right? Now we calculate its value. So, its determinant will be I into, we will take this with respect to y. So, this will be A1. And minus of this we will do with respect to z. So, we will get minus of A1 minus minus will give A1. Then minus j will take derivative with respect to x. What will come here? Minus A2. And if we take this again with respect to z, then we will get minus A2. In the same way, when we do this here, students, k will come. When we will do this with respect to x, then this will be a3. If we do this with respect to y, we will get minus minus of a3. Here we'll watch that. This minus minus is plus and becomes 2a1i. Then we will get minus 2a2 and minus minus is plus. So this will be 2a2j. And students, this also will be in plus. We will get a3k. So students, take 2 common from here and this will be a1i. Plus a2j plus a3k. And students, this will be 2a vector. So, in this way, we can very easily prove it, right? Let's move on. We gave its proof here. Next question, it is asking you to find its divergent and its curl. Finding divergent is very easy if you want to do that. So, what do we do? The derivative of I with respect to X is 2X, right? The derivative of J with respect to Y is 2X. And the derivative of K with respect to Z is 0. So by this, we will get 4X. If we do it by method, we'll get del dot F. Write del, write F and calculate dot product. Ultimately, it will be the same. Now we'll talk about finding its curl. So how do we find the curl? It's same. I, J, K, del by del X, del by del Y, del by del Z. We will write the coefficient of I, J, K in these places. And we'll find its determinant. This will give the answer. So you can do it easily. Let's move ahead towards the next question. Determine the value of constant A, B, C if this is irrotational. It says, if this is irrotational then. What will be the values of A, B, C? So write I, J, K and coefficients here and make it equal to 0. Because if this F is irrotational, we know that value of its curl will be 0. And let's do one thing, write here 0i. Plus 0j plus 0k, write 0i here. Plus 0j plus 0k. So when we expand this, here also we will get the coefficients of I, J and K, right? Coefficient of I is equal to I, coefficient of J is equal to J, coefficient of K is equal to K. And this C plus 1. What will this become? Students, C plus 1 will be 0. In the same way, A minus 4 will become 0. Similarly, B minus 2 will be 0. So the value of C will be minus 1. Value of A is 4, value of B is 2. Now you will ask, where did we get these value from? It's determinant value. There's a correction. Here we have plus C. So when its derivative is with respect to Y, you'll get C. When it's with respect to Z, then minus plus C plus 1i. Similarly, when you do it with respect to X and Z, then you'll get these values. Similarly, you will do it here and compare it to 0. We will get values of A, B, C in this way. Let's move ahead. The next question, what is the value of the divergent F, where the value of F is given? So, first we need to find its value, then we will take the divergent of this. This is del. So, what is its meaning? Ultimately, del of F means you have to apply del of this scalar. That means you have to find the gradient, right? Find the divergent of gradient, right? You need to understand this. So, firstly, we will apply del to this, and we know derivative of this with respect to X will be I. Derivative of whole with respect to X will be I. Derivative with respect to Y will be J. Derivative with respect to Z will be K. Remember, del by del X, del by del Y, del by del Z, that will go with it. So, we will get its value. Now, we have to find its divergent. We will find its divergent. We know that the divergent of F, its value, what is its value? It is I, del by del X, J del by del Y and K. We'll give del by del Z and dot. Students, in this dot, here we will have this entire value, right? This value will come, right? So, we know that I dot I, what is that? It is 1. What will we write? This will be del by del x of and this will be 3x square minus. 3yz plus j dot j is 1. So students, it will be 3y square minus 3x z. In the same way, del by del z of students, it will give 3z square minus. We will get 3xy. When we differentiate this, it will be 6x. This will be 6y and this 6z. In this way, we can easily do it. Students, thank you so much. How did you like the video? Please comment and let me know. If you want to see more videos on vector calculus, you can see them here. If you are preparing for CSIR, NET, GATE or IIT-JAM exams and want to improve your short tricks. So students, you can check complete playlist here and subscribe to the channel. Thank you all very much. Bye.